love.
Dalawa na lang ating candidates na magtatanong at sasagot sa ating preliminary question and answer. At bubunot ako kung sino ang magtatanong sa inyong dalawa, ladies. Ang magtatanong ay si candidate number one. There you go, candidate number one. At si candidate number six ang iyong tatanungin.
Hey, Ma'am Shi.
Hello.
So, here is my question. How will you convince a student not to attend classes? Again, paano mo makukumbinsi ang isang estudyante na hindi umattend sa kanyang klase?
Okay, ang katanungan daw po ay humihindayag sa ganito pamamaraan. Paano ko raw po makukumbinsi ang isang estudyante na hindi pumasok o umattend sa kanyang klase? Marahil nagtataka po kayo na ang katanungan po ay talagang mali po sa pananaw at paningin po ng iba. So, ang estudyante, sasagutin ko po ito na naayon sa aking opinion. Lahat po ng mga bagay dito sa ating mundong ginagalawan ay mga may kasiyahang kapalit na nangyayari. Nagkakamali po tayo pero ang kapalit po nito ay may kasiyahan. Kaya makukumbinsi ko po siya na hindi po umattend ng klase niya at gawin po ang mga bagay na mabuti sa likod po ng mga bagay tulad ng pag-attend ng kanyang klase. Pwede naman pong pumunta tayo ng library para mag-aral o magsaliksik sa mga kaalaman. Nang sa gayon, kinabukasan, kung papasok po man tayo sa ating klase, mas may matututunan po tayo at may sasagot sa kahit man ang mga leksyon na itinuturo po ng ating guro. Ngunit lagi po nating pakatandaan na anuman pong mali o tama dito sa ating ginagalawan, gawin po natin kung anong nararapat. Ako bilang isang estudyante o kayo bilang isang estudyante na mga nanonood dito sa patimpalak na ito, gawin niyo po kung anong tama. Sa mga kabataan na nandito ngayong patimpalak na ito, wag po kayong magkahating o wag po kayong mimiss o magmimiss po sa isang klase upang mamiss po ang kaalaman na dapat inyong matutunan. Bagkus pag-aralan niyo po mabuti kung ano po ang tama at kung ano ang mali. Sapagkat ang ating eskwelahan at ang ating edukasyon ang siyang magpapaangat sa atin patungo sa ating tagumpay. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very, very much, candidate number 6. Now it's your turn naman para magbigay ng question kay candidate number 1.
Okay. Okay, this is my simple question, candidate number 1. Why pineapple called pineapple, but there's no pineapple inside of it? Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much for that very interesting question. And it is actually entertaining, to be honest. But I'm standing here as a representative of lesbians, gays, bisexuals, and transgenders out there. And the question was down to my shoulders about pineapples. Well, you know what? Pineapples are made of a fruit wherein they are actually fully notated under fructose, the loyalty on science, and it is actually nutritious inside and outside. And definitely, pineapple has many eyes and it can see every different ideology. And to enter the mystifying way of mythological about the pineapple, well, I can definitely tell everybody, why does pineapple called pineapple if there is no apple inside of it? Maybe that is just the scientific name by naming the pineapple itself. All things here in this world are created because of its meaning. And therefore, I could say that juxtapositional way of believing that pineapple is pineapple and through nutritious, even though there is no apple inside of it. Definitely, ladies and gentlemen, you can definitely eat that fiber in order for you to get nutrition, because I always believe that health is wealth. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much. Candidate number 2. Candidate number 2. Okay, candidate number 2, please. Bulat ka dito sa ating fishbowl kung sino ang iyong tatanungin.
Candidate number 5, Patty. Hi, Sis.
Hi, Sisi.
Ito na naman tayo. So my question is, what is the bravest thing you ever did for love?
I think the bravest thing I've ever done for love was to commit to someone who is 1,000 miles away from me. I've been in a long distance relationship for 4 years. And this was my last relationship and it ended last year in the month of November. And for those you who haven't experienced a long distance relationship, you experience, you know, longingness of being so far or so distant from the person you love. But as long as you believe that that person is the one that is meant for you, if you truly feel that that person is worthy of your time, of your respect, and your loyalty, then I believe that it is okay for you to do a long distance relationship, even if you are so far away from one another. Because as long as you keep communication as number one part of priority, and God as the center of your relationship, then your relationship will definitely be forever. And that, my dear friends, is my answer. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much, candidate number five. So, candidate number five, please join me here. And pick one dito sa ating fishbowl. At siya naman ngayon ang iyong tatanungin. At ang iyong napili, I see, candidate number two.
Lars. Okay, what is your opinion about the Philippines ranking the third country to be the most polluted all over the world in terms of plastics?
All right, thank you so much for the wonderful question. The question that was given to me is that what is my stand about our country ranking third on this spot being polluted? You know what, ladies and gentlemen, I believe na nararanasan na natin ngayon ang ganti ng ating inang kalikasan. Baha, lindol, at kung ano-ano pa. And you know what, ladies and gentlemen, what is my stand about this? There's this one thing I would like to say to everyone. Let us all be responsible. Because I believe, ladies and gentlemen, that everyone is responsible with their actions. Well, then definitely, there is no problem about the pollution, about being destroyed by our Mother Earth. Because always remember, ladies and gentlemen, na nagiging makasarili na ang mga Pilipino. Pinuputol ang mga puno sa kagubatan upang gawing subdivision. Idinatapon ang mga kemikal sa ilog na nanggagaling sa mga pabrika. Always remember these, ladies and gentlemen, when all trees are cut down, when all waters are polluted, we can never ever eat money. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much, candidate number two. So ang ating mabubunot, bubunot siya dito sa ating fishbowl. At siya ang tatanungin ng candidate number na ito. Ang ating first candidate na magtatanong ay si candidate number seven, Francine Garcia. Francine, bunot ka dito? Ayan. So ang tatanungin ng candidate number 7, I see.
My favorite candidate, candidate number 4, Matrica May Centeno.
Ayan o!
Hi, Mother.
Okay.
So it's been 5 years.
Yes. Okay. I miss you on the stage.
I miss you too and I miss everyone. Okay, so this is your question. Kung may ipaparetoke ka pa sa akin. Siyempre, hindi yung tanong ko. Aside from you, because given, for example, you are not competing tonight, who do you think should win the competition?
Oh, shit.
It's too hard, actually, to choose because all of them are dear to my heart. It's a common note to everyone and knowledge na lahat ng mga ito malapit sa puso ko. May mga iba't iba kaming pinagsamahan, pero kung babalansihin ko, let us still put it this. The competition is not only about how we portray ourselves on the top of the stage. All of them are beautiful in their individual way. All of them are very much intelligent. But regardless of that, who really stood up in reciprocating, meaning to say someone who could really be an inspiration from the very, very start. Dahil ang inahanap ko lang ngayon, hindi lang yung reign ng maganda at matalino, bagkus kung paano ipinaglalaban ang mga karapatan ng LGBTIQ sa panahon ngayon. And I find this girl really not because you said a while ago that I am your favorite, But definitely within my heart, alam ko kung gaano kasensitibo to pagdating sa pakikipaglaban, sa pagtamasa, sa pag-angat ng mga LGBTIQ. So it's there for candidate number 7. Not because she's a super Sereno winner, but I saw everything from the very start. Why are you joining? Me, I'm joining because for my family. Me, I'm joining because for the plight of my younger brothers and sisters. And that's why they graduated in college, the 8 of them, because we're 11. 8 of them graduated in college because of me joining in the beauty pageant over the 3 decades ago. But this young girl really joined pageant, not only because her beautification, but all throughout, most of the time talaga, sinasabi niya sa akin, ayaw kong magmukhang katawa-tawa ang mga bakla. And that from my itself, I'm saying, I'm loving this candidate number 7. All of them, or all of us, are initially competing this pageant tonight. But definitely, judges and to all the audience, hindi kailanman magkakaroon ng makabuluhang pangyayari ang pagtayo mo sa bawat entablado kung ang corona mo'y kumikinang para lang sa physical mong anyo at hindi tumutusok sa bawat puso na maging inspirasyon ka sa lahat. Thank you.
Maraming salamat, candidate number 4. Okay, so with that, candidate number 4, ikaw naman ang mabibigyan ng chance para bumunot kung sino naman ang tatanungin mo.
I pick number 7.
No. Bunutin mo yan. Okay, so yung number 7, ibabalik na natin dito.
Okay.
Okay, so ang tatanungin mo ngayon ay si candidate number 3.
Okay, kaapelyido ko. Anak-anakan ko. Okay, Alexis Romualdez Centino. Here is your question. Hi, Nakshi.
Hello, mother.
Judges, candidate number 3. Your question is, I just have only a simple question for you. Do you think winning a crown makes you beautiful? Thank you. That's it.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a very timely and beautiful question. Being on this platform tonight, a lot of young trans women would think and look up to us as people who they idolize and who they respect, or sometimes they try to imitate. But then again, winning a pageant for me is not just winning. You know, when you're crowned and you have something shiny in your head, it isn't that. Because being beautiful is not just something physical. Beauty, ladies and gentlemen, my dear panel board of judges, is not a thing one person can acquire or consume. It is something that you just have to be. And what actually should sustain us from what is fundamentally beautiful should be our compassion for ourselves and for those who are around us. Because that kind of beauty is the kind of beauty that people sometimes somehow tend to forget. And physical beauty isn't everything. It isn't what is essential. For what is beauty, my dear panel, board of judges, if you yourself, as a beauty queen, as a contender for a pageant, have not done anything for humanity? If that's what it takes for me to win or lose a pageant, then so be it. I will never ever bend my understanding of what I think is right, correct, truth, and what is acceptable. Thank you very, very much.
Maraming salamat, candidate number 4. Or rather, candidate number 3. Alright, so ikaw naman ngayon, candidate number 3, ang bubunot dito sa ating fishbowl kung sino ang iyong tatanungin para sa ating preliminary question and answer. At ang iyong tatanungin ay si candidate number 7.
Hello,
ate. Hi. Oh my gosh. Ate Francine, this is one of the questions I actually find the hardest, and hopefully we get to hang out after this.
Reminder lang, 5 years akong hindi nag-contest, ha? Ago.
Alright, my question is, how do you convince an atheist that God is a woman and not a man?
Okay, so how do I convince an atheist that God is a woman and never a man? Ladies and gentlemen, in our existence, we used to call God, Allah, Buddha. It depends on our beliefs. But ladies and gentlemen, an atheist, how can I convince him that God is a woman? simply by saying that no person has ever seen God, so no person can give gender to our God. Just like how we call Him, God, Allah, or Buddha. He is still our supreme being. Just like our gender, we have the right to proclaim our gender identities. So therefore, if I believe that my God is a woman, then you should accept it and respect that my God is a woman. Thank you. 4 years.
Thank you very, very much, candidate number 7.